Oh, it was Bauer here to review the Kamen Rider Saber DX Eineken Noroshi. So this is the main transformation Seiken of Kamen Rider Sabella. She appeared, I think, in the mid-20s. So this is our first of two premium Seikens. Obviously, as you can see right here, Kamen Rider Sabella herself, the Eineken Noroshi, the Konchu Daiyaka Wonder Ride book. I don't know what the first one is, because typically I don't know what the red means. I know the blue means sounds. Obviously, you get wonder text and such. The box is really neat, but I got mine banged up. Is this literally the same picture? So there's a two close up on Sabella herself. I don't think you get anything here. Then you get Sabo in the back, and just like the 01 Memorial sets, you're able to connect this with the next review. So I won't be able to show it because it's too big. So let's take a look at it. So here we have the set. Obviously, we got the Wonder Ride book, but most importantly, we got the Seiken itself, to which obviously. This is what the second Henshin Seiken I've picked up because obviously I only have the Ōchūken Susanoo. I don't have the Gekido or Hayate. I like the design of this one overall. I like that it's more of a rapier kind of weapon, like more like an actual rapier than the Kyu rapier. But I like the hilt. I like the size of it overall. I like the colors. I like the maroon. On this, we don't have much maroon, and the gold coloring on it is really nice. And I just like, I think this, I'm not, I don't know, I'm kind of, I guess, mixed on the locomotive slash steampunk designs, but like, I really like it here and such, because as you can see, all the molded tubing and such, obviously, coming from the sword, obviously, the blade is. Pliable, and I really like this curved piece within it. Again, I think there is. I don't think there is silver paint, but obviously there's gold. There is Wonder Mark there. This is obviously where you slot in the Wonder Ride book. Obviously, as you can see from here, it's handled differently. This is the Hisatsu button. This is the button to eject. Trigger button. There's the rider mark for Sabella, which is kind of scary that it's literally just up here because obviously you can literally get this scratched. And the back is not really much. However, there is this to which you can indeed slot this in a Hisatsu holder. I don't think she's ever done this. I, oh, of course. But even better, just get that prepared. You can put it in a sword driver or blade driver. This is amazing. I think this is the other only other Seiken you can. This is the only one. This is the only other one you can fully put in. Because technically you can't put the entirety of the Hayate in. You can only put in one half. So that's hilarious. So again, just like the Susanoo, just pull the pull tab, and then again you just get this one singular attack sound. And I forgot to show this in the demo, but if you press this with no Wonder Ride book. You don't get anything. So let's take a look at the Wonder Ride book. So here's the Wonder Ride book. Konchu Daiyaka or Haka. Konchu Daiyaka. Yaka? Konchu Dai Ha, whatever, Insect Encyclopedia. The cover is definitely interesting, and obviously the Wonder Ride book as a whole, like the cover page is definitely interesting, because this is obviously a new mold, including the secondary page. Everything else is still the same, but it's still in the maroon color, and now the secondary color, instead of being black, is gold, because Sabel is part of the southern base. And you can tell, or as you can see right here, we finally got a beast or animal book. And then back is the same, but now the wonder mark is gold. Again, the story page is now actually new also. And then the wonder text. Again, there's multiple insects, and then the QR code for Gomberizing. And then the transformation page for Sabella. It's very refreshing to actually have a transformation page for these books. So the pressing sounds are different. And the book activation. Yep, you really have to push out this part. There's the story activation. Obviously, you know, for those curious of whether or not you can actually blow it. Let's see if I can get this. Yep, you just have to, well, you, obviously you just have to have this open and then like really have to blow hard. So obviously just like these Henshin Seikens, just activate the Wonder Ride book. Slot it in like so. Then we get the standby, and then obviously press the trigger. So there we get the transformation for Kalmar Sabella, and it's really nice, obviously, that we finally have a device for the female voice from Emotional Dragon. I forgot I put it back. So it's nice that she finally has a device respected for her. And then, obviously, you still get the main voice of the Saber stuff as a whole. But, yeah, the Wonder Ride book is kind of weird now. Like, I don't know, because it's just, it's flap is just... I feel like it, like, again, like, I feel like the flow is just kind of weird, but other than that, obviously, that's still retained and such. So what makes this different from the previous three Henshin Seikens is that you don't need to remove the Wonder Ride book in order to initiate the finishers. You didn't, as you even heard, it didn't even, like, say the name of the Wonder Ride book. Because obviously that was within the jingle. It didn't even say the name of the Seiken. So the jingle within this one is definitely more in line with the Sword Driver jingles. Instead of the Henshin Seikens, which is pretty neat. But again, to activate the finishers, you press this gold button right here. Really like the standbys for this thing. Second finisher, press it twice. This toy makes you press this thing in full, because as you can see, I typically do half presses, which obviously doesn't do anything. But for the final finisher, you would expect it to press it three times, however, you actually have to hold it down. That should help not wash out the Wonder Ride book and such. But yeah, that's essentially it. So again, to eject the book, just press this down and pull it out. Now, you know, despite the fact that she doesn't form change at all, they actually incorporated an entire second sound set when you hold down the trigger button. So now, you know, when you use another Wonder Ride book, so obviously we're going to use the legendary Kieran Scares Kid. And set it in like so. We get a Wonder Rider jingle, which I really like. Like, this is really cool. Like, I think this is just... I kind of really wish the other three Henshin Seikens had this. I understand why they don't. Or especially the Gekido and Hayate. The Susanoo, it's like... It already had two transformations. So this is on par with that. And on top of that, we actually get three new finishers. So, as you can tell, the sounds, the finisher sounds are the same, but, you know, different announcements. And then, obviously, switch it back. You actually get the announcement of the Seiken. Again, something I kind of wish the other three Henshin Seikens had. But yeah, that'll have to do with the Seiken itself. Let's take a look at the Wonder Ride book and all of our Saberisms. Now we can actually do this. I don't even know how to frame this anymore. So there we finally get the Wonder Rider with the Kono Dobutsu, and it actually says Konchu, which is pretty neat that this book is actually programmed within the Sword Driver itself. Obviously the Wonder Attack. Hisatsu Doka. Transitioning. Then the Kyomu, you want the transformation. Come on. This one's finicky. Obviously, this is still orange, so this worked naturally. Again, the transformation. So, yeah, obviously, because it is a main Wonder Ride book, it does say Eternal Power, and it does say the, like, animal thing. Kurayami. So, interestingly enough, all of these say Komchu, which is interesting and such. Obviously, I don't really mind, but yeah. So that'll have to do with this. Nope. Overall, my thoughts on the Ine Kanoroshi is that I really like it overall. I think it's probably one of the best looking Seikens, because, you know, like, it's just, you know, I like how sleek looking it is and such. You know, like, I think I already went over it. I just like how simple it looks. I like its sleekness. I like its slimness. I like the sounds it has. I think the functionality is pretty straightforward. And, you know, just, I think the only thing that I'm kind of not really, about is just the Wonder Ride book, but obviously, I should probably state this, obviously, Reika underhands this thing, so it makes a lot more sense. So, like, I think, you know, obviously, when you underhand it, it makes a lot more sense, but obviously, when it's like this, it just, it doesn't look great. What the heck? Oh, those are vice stamps. But other than that, like, I don't really know what much I can really say about this, because I think this is just a perfect Seiken. I'll even say it's a bit better than the Susanoo. Oh, because, you know, I don't have to deal with the finickiness of, like, having to, like, you know, like, do that. Because I don't understand why they thought that was a good idea for the other three Henshin Seikens, because they all should have just had their own sounds incorporated in them, but I guess they really wanted that Wonder, or they wanted that, you know, he sucks read in some way. But other than that, pricing in the aftermarket, it's, I think this is $120, which is not really worth it. Really cannot really get on with that price. It's only worth half that price. So you can get this for 60 and I guess sacrifice batteries? It's worth it? No. But yeah, this is going to be a hard find. So I apologize for that, but you know, it really, you know, you're really only going to get the one name announcement within the Seiken, which is why I didn't really bother going for the Gekido or Hayate. So, at the end of the day, it's optional. So that will be it for this review.